So good morning, myself Dr. R. Ragu from Physics Department. So today we are going to see the topic called Particle in One Dimension Box, that is Particle in Infinite Potential Well. So consider a particle of mass m that is moving between two rigid walls, that is x is equal to 0 and x is equal to a along x axis. So inside the box the potential energy is considered to be 0 and outside it is infinite. So from this we frame two equations, v of x, that is potential energy v of x is equal to 0 for 0 less than x less than a, and another condition is v of x is equal to infinity for 0 greater than or equal to x greater than or equal to a. So based on this, from Schrödinger wave equation in one dimension box is given by d square psi by dx square plus 2m by h cut square e minus b into psi is equal to 0. So here we get the basic equation e minus b. Here the v of x is equal to 0, substitute this in first equation, we will get d square psi by dx square plus 2mb by h cut square into psi is equal to 0. So instead of this 2mb by h cut square, we can take a constant k square. So substitute this in above equation, we will get d square psi by dx square plus k square psi is equal to 0. So the basic solution for the above equation is psi of x is equal to a sin kx plus b cos kx. We are seeing above the, we are having only one particle, but we get two constants here. So our duty to find in which constant the particle is present. So by applying boundary conditions, we can get it. So from x is equal to 0 and psi is equal to 0, we applied in the above equation, we will get a sin 0k plus b cos 0k. Here sin 0 is 0, so automatically the term a will become neglected, and cos 0 is 1, so the b term will be 0. So hence we can found that particle is not present in the constant b. So it is our duty to find where it is present. So applying this wave function in another same equation, we will get a sin k is equal to 0. Here we can get sin a is not equal to 0 because the particle is present only in a. So we need to make the sin k is equal to 0. So by taking k is equal to n pi, then we will get k is equal to n pi by a. So in previous slide we will know that the k square is equal to 2 mu by h cut square. So here we need to take square on both sides, we will get k square is equal to n square pi square by a square. From that equation we will get the h cross square, there is a reduced Planck's constant value is h by 2 pi. Here it is h cross square, so we will square this equation, we will get h square by 4 pi square. By simplifying this equation, we will get the value of k square is equal to 8 pi square mv by h cut square. So from the above equation, we can equate the equation 6 and 7, we will get n square pi square by a square is equal to 8 pi square mv by h square. So we need to find the value of eigenvalue and that is the energy of the particle. So we will get En is equal to n square h square by 8 ma square. So in fourth equation we will get psi of x is equal to a sin kx plus b cos kx, but we know the particle is not exist in b. So we will know the value of k is equal to n pi by a. So from the fifth equation we will substitute in fourth, we will get wave function psi n of x is equal to a sin n pi x by a. So again you will get the value of a by normalizing this wave function. So probability density function is given by psi star psi is equal to a square sin square n pi x by a. So we will integrate with limit from 0 to a. So 0 to a square sin square n pi x by a into dx is equal to 1. Here the constant a is, we can take it out, and we will apply this trigonometric formula that sin square theta is equal to 1 minus cos 2 theta by 2. Based on that we will modify this equation and we will get this type. So after that we will apply the limit. So the second term, that is sin 2 n pi x by a divided by 2 n pi a, will neglected while applying this both limit 0 and a. So we will get a square by 2 into x. So while applying 0 this term will neglect, while applying a we will get a square by 2 into a is equal to 1. So we will shift this 2 to that side, means 2 by a will come. We need to know the value of a only, so we will take in square on both sides, we will get a is equal to root 2 by a. So by knowing the value of root 2 by a, we will substitute in the